Well, let's take a look at some of these masks. Our Jiminita Swain met some local mask designers who are putting their sewing skills to the test.
Face masks are a new requirement for residents, and many designers are putting their skills to the test to supply those face masks for eager clients. Two designers, Annelle Dillette and her brother Cedric Bernard, have pulled out the needle and thread and pulled together some fabulous design of face mask. Dillette spoke to ZNS News via telephone Thursday, explaining how the project came together.
I made up a quick ad. A family member did a quick ad for me. They shared it on WhatsApp, and 10 masks then became into 100 masks. So now there's a large order being filled for a security company. There's an order being filled for a bank. So it just started to grow and grow. And as we speak, persons WhatsApp me, oh, I understand that you're doing masks. I'd like 10 masks. I'd like 20 masks.
Annelle Michelle, as she's known in the design world, spends her time in a sterile environment at home sewing and making face masks to supply the growing demand.
We're spraying the Lysol, making sure everything's clean. We wear gloves. We package the mask in plastic bags, in the Ziploc baggies. When persons place their order, they're like, okay, how do I get the mask? And I explain, I don't go to nobody's house. Nobody comes to my house. We meet at a rendezvous point. Probably a major supermarket. They have the exact change. I'm wearing gloves and my mask, and I just do the exchange.
The designer says in the week and a half, she's made about 300 face masks, and she is content in doing her part to help her country.
It's been a very rewarding experience. You know, this time of the year, you have persons calling. They want prom dresses. They want wedding gowns. And, of course, the demand for that is at zero. So to be able to use my gift for something different, for something that's going to save lives, I mean, it's so empowering, you know, as a young Bahamian woman, to be able to continue to provide for my family during this time.
Her brother, Cedric, echoes similar sentiments. He says although COVID-19 eliminated a number of events, mask making has kept their business afloat. The Prime Minister has also banned the importation of non-medical protective masks to protect the local mask manufacturing industry. The move, the Prime Minister says, was one to protect and encourage small businesses.
The functions and weddings and stuff in general was cancelled. Everything was at a low until the mask started. So when the mask started, then things started piecing back up during the mask and so forth. So I said, I'll say yes to that.
Dillette says she will spend the Easter weekend filling orders. Jiminita Swain, ZNS Network News.